Good afternoon, everyone. I am Bharat Kumar, working as an assistant professor, St. Mary's Engineering College, Department of Public. So today I would like to explain about two-fold network. So generally, is it very easy to analyze the any network if it is represented with the equivalent circuit? So if any network is represented with the equivalent circuit, then it is easy to analyze. Okay, it will establish the relationship between the input and output. Okay, so that's why we are going for the two-port network. So in order to analyze the any network by equating this network into equivalent circuit, we can understand, we can analyze. So first, we will define one port network first. So the name, by default, it will define the, the network which is having one port only. Port means, it is a pair of terminals. Okay, I will draw the one port network. So this is the network. So this is having only one port. Okay, the network which is having one port is called, that is called one port network. So this is having only one port. So one port means it is a pair of terminal. So one terminal is used to enter the current into the network. One terminal is used to leave the current from the network. Right. So we can denote this pair of terminals with one dash. This is about one port network. One port network is a network which contains the one port only. So here, port means pair of terminals. So one terminal is used to enter the current into the network. One terminal is used to leave from the current from the network. Now two port network. The name should suggest that network which is having two pair of terminals, then the network is called two-port network. So two-port network having two pair of terminals. So this is the one port, this is the another port. So first port, that is called input port, we can define. We can ask defined as input port. Second port as output port. Okay, I will indicate the terminals 1-2-2-. Okay, so first port, in the first port which is denoted with 1-1-. So from this here, the current I1 will be entering into the network and the same current will be leased from the network by using 1-port, 1-terminal. So yes, similarly, at output port, so through the second terminal, the current I2 will be entering into the network, from same current will be used from the network through the 2-. Okay, like that you can define the two port network. Now see, here we are applying the voltage V1 here, we are applying voltage here V2. So here V1, V2, I1, I2. So total 4 variables, V1 and V2 and I1 and I2. Okay. So by selecting any of two from this variable, we can make the six pair of equations. Okay. So how many variables means here? V1, V2, I1, I2. So total 4 variables. From total 4 variables, by choosing any two variables as dependent variable, we can make the 6 pair of equations. Okay. So this each equation will be represented with the dependent variables in terms of independent variables. The coefficient of independent variables are called parameters. The coefficient of independent variables are called parameters, network parameters. Now I will I will classify this this equations. So based on these four variables, I will choose two variables as dependent, two variables are independent, so that I can make six set of equations. Okay, first. So according to that, we can define the, we can classify the parameters into six types. First one is z parameters. Third one, second one is y parameters. Third one is transmission line parameters. We can write like that, transmission line parameters. Are also called ABCD parameters. Fourth one is inverse transmission line parameters. Are also can define these parameters with the A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash. Fifth one is hybrid parameters. So we can denote it with H parameters. Sixth one, last one is inverse hybrid parameters. Inverse hybrid parameters, we can denote it with H dash parameters. Or we can write Z parameters also. So by choosing any two variables as dependent, any two variables as independent, we can make the six set of equations, that is six set of parameters. So first one is z parameters, y parameters, transmission line parameters, inverse transmission line parameters, hybrid parameters, inverse hybrid parameters are also called z parameters. Here z parameters are also called open circuit parameters. I will explain why it is called open circuit parameters. And next, y parameters also called short circuit parameters. Now I will write the equations for the each parameter. So those equations are also called governing equations of the this parameters. So for this first z parameters, in case of z parameters, dependent variables are v1 and v2. So in case of z parameters, v1 and v2 are the dependent variables. So I will write this dependent variables in terms of independent variables. So v1 equals to z11 i1 plus z12 i2, and then v2 equals to z21 i1 plus z22 i2. So I told the coefficients of these independent variables are called network parameters. So for in case of z parameters, this z11 and z12, z21, z22 are the z parameters. Z parameters. For in case of y parameters, I1 is right for the dependent variables. So I1 equals to can write y11 v1 plus y12 v2, and next I2 equals to same y21 v1 plus y22 v2. Okay, so in case of y parameters, y11, y12, y21, y22 are the y parameters. Okay, now for the transmission line parameters, v1 and i1 are the dependent variables. So we can write v1 equals to a into v2 minus v into i2, then i1 equals to c into v2 minus d into i2. So in case of this equation, a, b, c, d are the transmission line parameters. For in case of inverse transmission line parameters, V2 and I2 are the dependent variables. So for this, governing equations are V2 equals to, I can write A dash V1 minus B dash I1, and next I2 equals to, you can write C dash V1 minus D dash I1. So in case of this, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash are the inverse transmission line parameters. For H parameters, fifth one, V1 and I2 are the dependent variables. Okay. For Z parameters, I1 and V2 are the dependent parameters. So for H, V1 equals, we can write H11, H12, H21 plus H22. So here, what are the remaining parameters? V2 and I1. So you can write I1, V2. Okay, in case of G parameters, you can write G11 plus G12, G21 plus G22. So what are the remaining parameters? V1 and I2. So you can write V1, I2. So in case of H parameters, H11, H12, H21 and H22 are the H parameters. For in case of Z, G11, G12, G21, G22 are the G parameters, are also called inverse hybrid parameters, like that. So these are the governing equations of the different types of the parameters. Okay. Now I will explain why Z parameters are called open circuit parameters. So here, in case of Z parameters, if you take two port network, consider. This is the input port 1 dash, this is the output port 2 dash. Okay, now V1, this is the I1, and this is the V2, and this is the I2. So here, from these two equations, I can find the Z11 and Z21 by making this I2 equals to 0. I2 equals to 0 means, what is the meaning is, this output port will be open. Output port will be open. So by opening the second port, we are finding the Z11 and Z21. So here, if I2 equals to 0, I can write Z11 equals to V1 by I1. If I2 equals to 0, from second equation, I can write Z21 equals to V2 by I1. And next, coming to second case, I can find Z12 and Z22 by making this I1 equals to 0. So by making I1 equals to 0 means, by opening the input port as open circuit, I can find Z12 and Z22. So now, if I1 equals to 0, Z12 equals to, you can write V1 by I2. Z22 equals to, you can write V2 by I2. So in both cases, by opening the any one port, I am finding magnitude of these parameters, that means Z11, Z21, Z22 and Z11. So that's why these parameters are called open circuit parameters. Okay. Now, why parameters? Why parameters are called short circuit parameters? For in case of Y parameters, our governing equations are I1 equals to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2, I2 equals to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. Now see, how can you find this magnitude of this Y11 and Y2? Y21 means, by making this 0, by making the V2 equals to 0, I can find the magnitude of the Y11 and Y21. So by making the V2 equals to 0 means, V2 equals to 0 means, we have to short the second port. By shorting the second port, we are finding the y11 and y21. And second case, in order to find out the magnitude of y12 and y22, I am making v1 equals to 0. V1 equals to 0 means I am shorting the input port. So in both cases, by shorting the input port and output port, I am finding the magnitude of the this y parameters. So that's why these parameters are called y parameters. So this is about two-port network. Thank you so much.